guys. Mike Gross here at rockandguitarlessons.com and youtube.com/rockandguitarlessons1. That's the Nitty Gritty Dirt Band. Something about fishing here. I remember the song vaguely. It's Fishing in the Dark, per request of a new subscriber, Soon 2132. Good request, dude. Thanks for requesting it, or chick, guy or girl. I don't have anything from the Nitty Gritty Dirt Band, so now I do. Good song, man. It's got some good rhythm to it. The tuning, to my surprise, was drop D. So, and I know this because on my channel with these lessons, I try to get them the exact way these bands are playing them, get the right strings, frets, tunings, and all that. And knowing that, some of these bands change it themselves, but I'm trying to keep the integrity behind it and give you what the band's actually doing. So I was surprised that this was drop D tuning, but it was. So if you're ready, let's do it. You want a palm mute, and you're going to hit string 6 and string 5, and hit them together. So once, and then bring your first finger to 2A, and hit both those strings again, and then repeat all that. So we have three of them, right? One time is two movements. So that's three. So the next thing will be down up, palm muted on the open E and A, and then second fret A, first finger, and then a upstroke on the D string. Do that twice. I missed it. Okay, then when the vocals come in, it's pretty much the same. They change it slightly. It'll go. There's an extra strum in it. Opens, second fret A with the open E. Again, again. So we have open E and A again. This is all palm muted. Then go to the second fret, and now we're going to go down up on the sixth and fifth string. Then open on both. So we have second fret A, and then open D with an upstroke. So do that whole thing four times. So in essence, you basically have like, it's like six times of, you know, with those first two and then this one that has the four in it. You could do the same one for all of them, but I want to give you the way that it's actually being played. Then when it changes, go up to fret five with your first finger on the E and A, and we're going to do the same beat melody, okay? The only thing that's changed is the frettings that we're using. So palm mute, we're barring the fifth fret on the E and A, hit that once, then bring your third finger to fret 7 on the A, and then start it over, again, start it over, and this time, the third time that your finger comes down on fret 7, go down, up, then lift it off, we're barring, right, so it's 5-5, down, up, and then bring that third finger back to 7A, and then upstroke on the D, 5th fret. And that's why I'm saying to bar that, so you won't have to worry about anything on the 5th fret. And do that twice. Without palm muting, I want you to hear what that sounds like, because the notes will actually cut through better when you're not palm muting, so you can hear the actual notes a little clearer. It would be. Like if it was over here, you'd have. Okay, so have fun with that one, man. That's a great one. Like I said, it has really good rhythm to it. I'm liking it. So, anyways, if you're not subscribed to my channel and you're tuned in for the first time, or you've just watched it several times and not subscribed, go ahead and subscribe. It takes a second. Once you do that, send me whatever songs you've always wanted to learn. Have them played accurately the way your favorite bands are playing them, or your favorite songs guitar players are playing them. All right, and what else? The Ultimate Beginner's Guide DVD. That is $20 for the hard copy plus shipping. And if you want digital download, I got that available as well. Just hit us up at rockandguitarlessons@hotmail.com, and we'll get you set up. I know we need your email and your address, especially if you're getting the hard copy. And but anyways, my friend Matt right now is kind of handling that. Thank you, Matt. And my website is rockinguitarlessons.com. That's coming at the end of 2012. It's $25 a month to become a premium member there. Close-ups on both hands, every tuning you can think of. It moves slow. It's not a big theory-based thing. Anyways, I think it's going to be cool. Put a lot of thought into it, and it's not one of those things where you're going to have to be reading a book to figure out how to play. It's very user-friendly is what I'm getting at. So we'll talk to you later. Spread the word about me if you don't mind, and we'll see you next time. Come right back. We've got more lessons. Thank you.